In this video, we will talk about the Puppet Warp tool, a powerful Clip Studio Paint feature that gives us the chance to quickly change or deform the pose of a character in a smart way, even after we finish drawing it. While we're working on an illustration, a comic, or an animation, when it comes to changing the pose of a character or an object, usually redrawing it, completely or in part, is the only viable option. However, with the help of many Clip Studio Paint tools, this task can be simplified, making it less time-consuming. Among the several tools available, Puppet Warp is a truly unique and powerful one. With this tool available only in Studio Mode from Clip Studio Paint version 4.0, we can change the features of a design quickly while also retaining the harmony of the line art and, in case of the characters or some specific objects, avoiding distortions while keeping the proportions fairly intact. This feature finds its place virtually in any kind of artist's workflow, greatly speeding up the creative process. Let's see how it works. The way Puppet Warp works is quite unique. Once a layer, a group of layers, or a folder is selected in the layer window, the effect applies a triangular mesh all over the shape. This is done automatically. Once the mesh appears, it's possible to add pins. Selecting and then dragging any of the pins will deform the mesh surrounding the pins selected. Any pin that's not selected will keep the mesh fixed in place. Adding pins in strategic areas of the model allows for a seamless, organic transformation of the model. Now that we have an overview of what the Puppet Warp tool does, let's see in detail how to implement it. 1. First, we need to select a layer, or group of layers. Even a folder will do. This will be where our effect is applied. 2. Once the area is selected, all we have to do is select the Edit menu, go to Transform, and then tap Puppet Warp. The triangular mesh will appear immediately, covering the entire shape we selected. Remember that the line art outline has to be fully closed for optimal results. With the mesh showing, it's now time to place some pins. For simplicity reason, I'm going to pick a character. This way, the pin placement should be more obvious. To add the pin, all we have to do is to tap on the part of the mesh area where we want to add the joint. If we end up placing a pin in the wrong spot, just open the tool property palette and change from Select Pin to Delete Pin, or hold down the Option key, Alt key on Windows, using the Edge keyboard, and tap on the pin to remove it. Pins can be used both in areas that can act as a joint, or to keep a specific section unchanged during the editing process. Pins are a core feature of the Puppet Warp tool. There are two ways to make this happen. 1. Change the position of the pins by selecting them and moving them all at once. To select a pin, go to the Tool Property palette, then choose the selection method. Here you can choose between single or multiple. The pins can also rotate by dragging their outer handle. The changes can be confirmed by tapping OK on the Transform Launcher. Tip: selecting a certain area and an executed puppet work will only activate it in that area, making the effect easier to apply sometimes. To keep the boundaries of the selection attached to the rest of the image, just add some extra pin along the edges. Some Puppet Warp tool settings can be changed using the tool property window, but for a show of every single feature, we can open the Subtool Detail window by tapping on the Wrench tool icon. Let's take a look at some of the options available. 1. Expansion. The outer edge of the mesh can be expanded to cover areas that might be too thin to be automatically selected when executing the Puppet Warp tool. 2. Show Mesh. We can toggle on and off Show Mesh in case we want a clear vision of the areas we are editing. 3. Click Pin. This setting will help to switch between select or delete pins. 4. Select Pins. Let us pick between creating a new selection, add to the current selection, remove a selected pin or toggle between selections. Five, correct pin rotation. Enabling this will automatically rotate and adjust the pin while correcting other pins. Disable it to keep it fixed instead. 6. Order. Selecting one of the four behaviors will change how the affected area of the mesh will intersect with each other. This is all I have for you today, and I hope you enjoyed this Puppet Warp Tool breakdown video. As usual, if you liked this video, don't forget to leave a like, a comment, and to subscribe to the Clip Studio Paint official YouTube channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching.
Clip Studio Paint.